Hey, how's everybody doing? John Rock and TV One here. And today I am going to show you the Harbor Freight Chicago Electric 2.5 horsepower 10-inch brick and tile saw. And the stand and the Harbor Freight 10-inch diamond blade. All of which was purchased from Harbor Freight with 25% off coupons and all got to my garage $240 in change for all these three items. I make these videos so that you guys can see hands-on what these tools are and how they work and what to expect instead of just having to read the website reviews, which may or may not be skewed for reasons you can probably understand. So, without further ado, let's unbox this stuff and I will tell you what I see in the box, show you what I see in the box, and then compare it to what I read online before I made this purchase. I do have a paver stone walkway to put in. You guys hang out, subscribe, that'd be great. You'll see the paver stone walkway get put in. You'll also see the saw in use. So, let's unbox this stuff. Okay, so it is the Harbor Freight Warrior 10-inch diamond blade. Guys talk online about buying a quality blade. In case you want to see that, hopefully I got that framed up for you. They talk about buying a more quality blade, and a 10-inch diamond blade could be $70, $80, $90, depending on what brand you buy and where you buy it. So this saw does not come with a blade. You have to purchase one. If this blade does not hold up through my job, which is about 260 square feet, it's not huge, it's a walkway, and some block garden boxes, and you guys will see that. The stand is item number 69325, hopefully you can see that, and the saw is item 9275. It is 2.5 horsepower. Pretty substantial tool, I thought, to be able to get all of this stuff in the house for less than 250 bucks. Let's uncrate this stuff and talk about what I read online about this equipment. Okay, the stand itself, I actually did not do a whole lot of research on because, well, it's a stand, and hopefully it does what it's supposed to do, hold up the saw. And I'm going to imagine that as long as all the hardware that goes with is actually in here, that it's going to be able to do that. But I will let you see in the box, and then we are going to assemble this stuff right in front of you, for you, so that you can see exactly what we got here. Okay?
Okay.
And I actually am cutting this box open because I want to save the cardboard for some other project. Like a giant fan blade. Yeah. So let me figure out how to do that without wrecking the box squarely. It is stapled up pretty rugged, so you probably want to watch your fingers if you do that. And I don't really need that kind of, but I can slice through here. And if my blade's any good, that'll do, probably. There. There. Okay. So, that's what's in the box. Okay. This evidently is packing material. And maybe there is no assembly required on that. Let's just see.
That'd be great. Something I don't know how to put together. Nice plastic bag, keep it nice.
Okay, no assembly required on that.
Perfect.
Okay, so you can see that works. And I'm leaning on it, all 160 pounds of me. And so far, it holds up. It looks like it's a stand with wheels.
Great.
Little instruction manual that, yeah, we'll toss that to the side. And there is a couple of nuts and bolts are probably to tack down the saw with. I guess we'll have to figure out where those go. Probably right here and right here. So we'll see how that fits with the saw. Okay, as far as the saw goes, I did read all 64 reviews at the time of the making of this video about this saw. And the one thing guys talk about is a crunched, flattened out, watering, because it is a wet saw and it comes through with a pump, and missing hardware, the part that attaches the motor to the arm. So, at the store, I did take the time to open the top of the box and try to find the parts. However, it's a couple feet deep and I didn't want to make a mess all over the store. I probably should have. But here is a box of hardware. Not quite sure yet where that goes. The manual itself is pretty spotty, but it does give you a parts breakdown, but it does not tell you what is in the box or what's supposed to have, which I think they should, but they don't. So hopefully you guys are seeing it now. Let me see what we're seeing. What are we seeing? We're seeing in the box here? Okay, let's try to see in the box. So you got that hardware pile and this nice piece of cardboard for something else. I mean, styrofoam. I have what looks to appear to be the water pump, which I don't even believe I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna connect up a garden hose. So I don't even have to, anybody who's ever done this before, you know you make all kinds of ceramic or concrete mud in your thing, and it makes the pumps not last long. So I'll be using that for some other project.
Yeah. Set that off to the side.
That bag was wrenches there, by the way. Okay. When you do this, the guys that came through without any hardware, make sure you check the backing material, because you don't know where it might be at. Likely they threw them out, because I asked the guy at the store, how many of these saws have ever come back because they were missing hardware, and he said absolutely none. And I actually had to go to two stores to get this unit, which was the last one that they had. They sold 40 of them this week at my local store, which is actually 45 minutes each trip out here in southern New Hampshire. So, let me show you inside the box here what we got so far. Looks like the motor arm over there, and obviously the swing table parked here, the rail table, so far. So let's yard that out of there and throw it right up on the stand before it starts getting heavy, and that way we can stand up and work on it, you know, like a regular guy. Okay. To the best of my knowledge, on this saw, there is a little square crater in the pan, the water pan, and that is where the pump goes, and that is so that if you keep the water at the correct level, the sediments don't end up at the pump, at least as much. However, anybody who's ever done this before knows that it does, and it will. Okay, so there's the pot as it comes out of the box. No problem, I got that, no problem. And does it actually look like it has holes for the stand? I don't know yet. It does. It looks like the two bolts that they give you with the stand fit right here and there. So, how does that work out with the pins that are on there? Probably because nothing. The pins are just locators. Okay, click. I like it. Click. So far, click. How does that work? Are we where we're supposed to be? I think that worked out perfect. Anyway, you guys see that? Click. Click. Yeah, good. Okay, just pulling that out of the box, right here on the floor that I swept off so I could find stuff that falls out everywhere. There is this little steel piece of tubing. Not quite sure where that goes yet, but we will have to find out. However, it did fall out of this thing here somewhere. Little drain plug goes in the drain plug hole. Like that. So we will just throw that in the tub for now. But that's what I'm talking about. Guys that show up with missing hardware, make sure you dump your box out quick, because possibly it was there and you threw it out. Okay, now what do I got in the box? More packing material. Okay, more packing squares. Oh, we'll use that for metal casting somehow. I've been saving hoarding my styrofoam for lost foam casting. So you guys sub, you'll see some of that. We're making pistons on lids and all kinds of stuff. Engines, drilling engines, yeah, and paper stone walkways. So, next piece. I don't know what the next piece actually is. We haven't read the instruction book. All I did was peruse it. So we're gonna, you know, we're figuring this out like a guy. So this table pot, I'm imagining, goes on the table pot. Okay, so it is in a nice little baggie. Be sure you check these to make sure that all the hardware is not in the bag. It's attached and not on the floor, ends up in the vacuum cleaner. Okay. I also have this, what looks like a primary sediment tray. Hopefully you guys are seeing that. They got that taped in there, and I will probably leave that taped in there until I need to take it out. But that probably is this primary sediment tray, and most of your chippings and shavings will fall in these holes, and you can take that out every once in a while. It looks like it slides out. Remove the tape. So let's stick that on there. This is the front of the saw here, and I am imagining that that is some sort of stop. But we'll have to figure that out. Hopefully this goes on. I'm not quite sure. Let's try it. This looks like it goes like this. You measure it, something's going in the front. Hopefully you guys are seeing all right, and hopefully I'm just gonna slide this right on there for ya. Ain't quite sure what's holding us up there. I'm supposed to put it on from the back. Or what's this pin all about? It's like some sort of locking mechanism, but we might have to read instructions here. Oh, it is some sort of locking mechanism. Yeah. And this goes off from this direction. It looks like. right to here to line up. Goes right on good. And this is some sort of little lock there. Yeah. Okay. So you can evidently lock it so it doesn't slide out. Pull that so you can operate it, slide it in so it locks up. Okay. So that's how that works. Hopefully I wasn't in the way of myself and you guys could see that, all right?
Yeah.
So, what else we got here? What else we got in the box? More packing material. And this is handle with the hardware is actually in it. The miter gauge part, I don't believe that takes any hardware. It just sets on here. Click, click, one miter gauge, perfect. One miter gauge right on the saw. Click. Sweet. Sweet. Angle gauge. Whatever you want to call it. Perfect. I usually cut to a line. Unless I was to have some angle that was custom angle. And then I would be setting it with a protractor. Just to compensate for any error in these numbers. Which should be pretty close for the most part. Because you are having grout lines. But if you were butting tiles somehow, maybe up against the bathroom tub or something like that, and you needed the perfect angle, well, then you wouldn't want to use these numbers. You just use them to get close or whatever. Anyway, you guys know that. Okay, the motor part there. That's probably the beefy part. And like I said, we didn't read the instructions yet. So we're just finding out what we got in the box so far. Well, I got a handle that's left still, the pump, and a baggie full of wrenches. 1, 2, 3, about 5 Allen keys, and a whatever wrench that is. Okay, motor head. And it's not that heavy. They say 73 pounds on the side of the box, and I don't know what this is, but most of it's metal. Guys talk about the thing coming out of the box with a broken shield. Mine is not broken. And the motor is already mounted. Perfect. So I don't have to do that. The mounting point is actually 2 large bolts, it looks like. And I think I got a bag full of bolts right here. So I'm imagining that a couple of those are for that. We're going to find out here in a second. The other thing that guys talk about online on the Hobby Crane website is the coolant tubing, the water cooler, goes through this arm, and yes, it is smashed right flat. However, with a little bit of help and a little bit of working, shove a pencil in there overnight, it'll probably be good. I'm liable not to even use that thing, but then again, I might hook that directly to my garden hose. So let's see how this bolts on. Let me set this right here for a second. And yeah, it appears.
Yeah.
Okay, without going nuts and trying to figure out my language in the instruction sheet, kind of self-explanatory, is at least 1, 2, 3 holes and one of those pins, one of those circular pots that we're evidently going to need hanging out the back here. So that must fit in here to sleeve that hole, and that evidently is where that goes. So we will put that back in the hole. We like put that so I didn't lose it. Oh yeah, in this top. There it is. So these here sleeve parts go in the 4 back holes of the frame of the machine itself. So that would explain why 6 bolts. I got 2 here and 4 coming in from the back. And that's all the hardware there is, ladies and gents. So as long as I got 6 of them in here, we're good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4 long ones, 2 short ones. Pretty self-explanatory. Okay. Okay, so let's pull one of the long ones out. And one of the short ones out. And it looks like they both use the same size wrench. So that will be in this bag. And it likely the big one. Okay, so it's the big wrench out of the bag. And I probably would recommend that you run around with all of these wrenches and tighten up all of the nuts and bolts that they correspond to. Because likely they may be put together hand tight. So I got 4 bolts. And I'm looking, and 2 nuts, which is not cool if I need all of those. And there appears no threaded holes in there, so yeah, there may be something missing here, unless I could find some more down in the bottom of this box. Because it does not appear unless they thread into the backside here, which, well, we're going to find out. And it does appear that these are threaded holes. So that explains that. The four big ones go into threaded holes. Cool. So that explains the two nuts for the unthreaded holes on the inside. Perfect. So let's try to get that mounted on with two hands and a spare foot. Turn that around. Try not to cut my cord. Don't cut the cord yet. Okay. Take one of these here big long ones. Get in there. That's one partially started. Go to a diagonal hole. Get another one partially started. Stick the wrench in and get a couple more threads on them so you don't break nothing. Come around here. You guys are seeing this. Take the two that go in here and stick them through the holes. That way we get lined up more better for everything else. Then we can go ahead and start our, what do you call it, lock and washes, which looks like I need a wrench for, unless that's a double-ended wrench, which it appears not to be. That wrench is for the change of blade. Yeah, so I will have to pull out a, 1 second. Okay, these nuts appear to be 17 millimeter. 17. Okay. Get those soldered on there. And I believe I am going to put in the other two long bolts to make sure that the holes are all lined up good. Hopefully you guys can see this all right. A little bit of wiggling around just to make sure all the threads are good. We don't want nothing to get stripped out, bunged up. Nearing tight and stop. We'll tighten them all up after we got them all in, down where they go. Standard operation assembly procedure. Never tighten one bolt and try to put the rest in. Get them all down there, right near where they go. Try to hold on to your wrench so you don't drop it down the machine. Last one. Yep. There you go. Perfect. Okay. These tools. Stick the wrench on there, pull, wrench, pull, wrench, pull, wrench, pull, wrench, pull, wrench, pull, wrench, pull, wrench. Tight is right, two pipes broken. Wrench, pull. Wrench. And that's it. Done. Okay. So, what does that leave me? Pretty much nothing. So let's just look in the box again, see what I got left. Hopefully nothing. No spare parts. Remember, those sleeves go into four big back holes. If you find one on the floor, it just vibrated out. So, according to me, I'm not missing any hardware. It worked out good. There's nothing in the bottom of that box. Go on. Pack of material, and I got this handle, a pump, and an instruction sheet. Perfect. Wow. Why does it appear that this handle goes on the back? Because it sort of does, except that's on the wheels. So, probably, I should have this thing the other way around on this stand. Yeah, because there's no way to bolt the handle on the front here. I don't know if you see it. Yeah, let me do that again. Okay, so I got a handle, okay? And I got a wrench, looks like. And the bolts are already started in there, and that is the proper wrench. However, if you put the back of the saw, which is where the handle goes, you got nothing else to do but lift the wheels up when you get bolted down. So that's no good. So you got to have the wheels on the side of the saw that you're going to be working at. That way you've got a handle to pick up and actually use the wheels. So that appears to be the case. So let me flip that around. Now that it's all put together. Where do I grab it? What do I got to grab? Flip the saw around on the stand. Is that right? Not quite. Perfect. And my bolt holes look like they almost line up. Okay, perfect. Okay, perfect. So, there we go. So, the stationary feet are on the back of the saw, because that's where the handle is at. So if you actually want to be able to pick this up with the handle and use the wheels, then you've got to have the wheels pods the operator. Okay, let's do that. Okay, so this probably would have been a little easier if I had put this handle on before I installed the motor arm, only because it wouldn't be in the way of trying to wrench these, but it's not really that big of a problem at all. One handle, right there, perfect. Wrench goes up. Again, tight is right, too tight is broken. You might want to take it apart, I don't know why, but you might. Yeah, this might have been a little easier if you put this handle on before you install the motor, but it's okay, because we're done. Another couple of half a clicks and it's over on that. That's it. Good, good. Okay, so now where are we at? Evidently, the only couple of things we got left to do is to put a blade on and this little package of two bolts and washers that they gave you with the stand now can go into the motor, what do we got for a wrench on that? Which one is it? Okay, same as the handle. Perfect. And hopefully you can see this all right. Put washer. Hopefully they go in from the top and not the bottom, so I don't have to stand on my head to do it. Okay, a score for the engineers this time. Put in the other one while we tighten them down. Ah, okay, how do I got to do that? Maybe I gotta put the other one from the bottom. Let's see. And evidently you do. And another score from the engineer. Okay, they actually got this near and right. Awesome. Put those in, little crank to make sure they don't fall out on you. Don't have to kung fu grip them because they're just on there to hold it down. It's not going anywhere, it's pinned in. Pins are welded. Okay, we can throw that wrench in the box now. Never be seen again. Perfect. So what do we got? Okay, so what do we got? Well, we got a blade and a pump left to go, and that's it. And, yeah. Okay. Well, I guess you've actually got to put them in from the bottom, because that one didn't hold on, did it? Huh. Oh, there you go. There's a bonus for the thing. These here hold-out bolts go in from the bottom. Now, even though that threaded in there, you weren't holding on to nothing. So these go in from the bottom. Yeah. That would have been cool if I was just supposed to stand up and do it, but here, let me bend down and put that screw in. Okay. What? Okay, so, yeah, and it works. As supposed to. And so we have this blade to put on now. Okay, so what do we got to do to put that on? So far, we've not read the instruction sheet, and that's good. Because I don't know about you, but I don't like it. This looks like this just comes open. Yeah, that's a little bit flimsy, so I'd be careful about that. And are these screws are all in there? Yes, they are. Yeah, I'd be careful with that. That's definitely not that rugged of a hinge, and a little bit of over exuberance would certainly break that. There is a direction to this blade. They say this way, and that's the way it goes. It's like this. Okay? Okay. The locking mechanism here is just pull a small knob on the top, and she comes up. Now I got room to wear. There is a way to put that on there. Okay, that big one stays on the shaft, and the cup end faces out. Okay. Yeah. Flip. Click. Okay. Now with big wrench. What do I do with that big wrench? Does appear to be right hand thread. The spindle lock is right here. Spindle lock button. Be careful with that door. It's not, it's definitely plastic, and you know, this whole shielding is made of plastic, so you want this blade to be on there right. Guys did talk about that being plastic online, and that it could possibly come flying out of there if it ever broke. I've never seen one of these wheels break, ever, but there is a steel stud mounted in there that would probably direct it into the table if the blade ever did break. I don't know what you would have to be doing to make that happen, but no need to over-straighten that and strip your spindle lock out either. Kung Fu grip is not necessary on that. And it looks pretty straight. So there we go. Click. Nice. Nice. Okay. Okay, so the only thing we got left in the box is this air water pump. And like somebody said online, on the Hockey Face review page on this particle, the tubing down the bottom here is a little bit kinked where it goes through. However, my experience with rubber and latex tubing, which this probably is that it will eventually open up a bit. However, if it didn't look like it was going to open up for you, we will have to check the flow here and see how this works. Like I said, I might not even use this pump. I may just save it. But for the video here, I will show you, unbag it, and show you what it looks like. That's all. Then this is the table lock there. Click. Be sure to lock that before you move it around, because it will end up on the floor or ground or wherever you're working at.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do we got in this bag here? It is a pump. I think they said something in the neighborhood of 3 gallons a minute. So working out of a 5 gallon pail, you haven't got too long. But it does have this here piece of latex tubing. Yeah, how does that work? Let's see. Looks like one fits inside the other is how that actually works. But you're probably supposed to route it around this way. And it is this here pump. Jabio, whatever that means. PP399, whatever that means. The suction cup's on there, and it appears to have like a Scotch-Brite type of filter in there. So I'm certain that this comes apart. Doesn't appear to be any takedown, teardown instructions with that. But the... the tray comes out from the other side of the saw. So we will stick that in there like that. And the power cord will be coming out there. We'll put that where we can get to it and see how that works. And I guess I can, I got enough tubing to root this. Suction cup's a little bit strange there. But, yeah, you want this as unkinked as possible, I'm gonna imagine. And stick this down here like this, and it goes, one tube goes inside the other tube, like that. And this probably will need a little bit of heat. You could probably warm up a pencil or something in your hand and stick it in there, and it will straighten that pipe out, because it is a little bit on the mashed side from the way they package it. And it appears that it has a plug with a water thing on it there, and you will plug the power for the pump into that, like so. And slide a little rubber thing over it to keep most of the water out. You know, undo that if you want, if you're using that. And that will come on with the power switch. You don't have to do it separate. Good. Excellent. Well, like I said, I'm not going to be using that pump. I'm going to connect it to my garden hose and go like that. So I just have unlimited water supply, and I don't have to worry about gagging up the pump. And the unlimited water supply will hopefully keep my blade in decent condition, because that is a for certain. If you run one of these saw blades dry, you will kill it. So we just take that back out and rebag it. Okay, so I plugged this thing in, and we'll let you guys hear the motor. It is supposedly 2.5 horsepower, and you should read your instructions even after you watch this video, or before you watch this video, because they do talk about putting a drop of oil on the spindle of your machine before you put the blade on. And they also talk about what size extension cords to work with, and making what's called a drip loop so that water spray doesn't run down your cord into your power connection, possibly burning up either the equipment or flipping breakers for you, or becoming a hazard, electrically speaking. So you probably want to do that. I would just turn this on. Hopefully it's gonna come right on for us. On this side of the saw is the locks, the bevel mechanism back here, so we can make these. They do say it only does the three angles that it does because of the cutouts on the table. If this was your table saw, then, you know, some guys coat them up with plywood and there's all kinds of cuts in there. And then, well, you have that. But on this particular saw, you can't just pick any angle without cutting into your table. So you don't want to do that. I suppose you could if you set it so that the depth wouldn't get the table. But then again, you're doing something on your own there, and I didn't tell you to do it. Depth stop right here. So it could be at, you can set a depth. If you didn't want to break through, or you were doing just score cuts, whatever it was on maybe larger brick. So that's what that's for. So let me hit the power button and see what we get. Nice. Fire. Nice. Sounds like a big skill saw. So there you guys go. Thanks for watching. Like I said, go ahead and check out the instruction sheet before you run this, before you put it together, just so that hopefully I help some of you guys out there. And if you'd like to see this saw in action, be sure and subscribe and check out my favorite walkway video up and coming.
Thanks for watching, John Rocket TV. One said that. Peace out.